The Fimir, a mysterious ancient race bound in their service to the Chaos Gods, makes their way into Warhammer 3 courtesy of the OVN Lost Factions mod. We're just going to go through some of the units in the army and see what it has to offer. Kicking it off with the big legendary lord, Kroll. This octopus lady is not only a massive melee behemoth with a big old weapon strength, armor piercing, bonus versus infantry, but she's also a caster as well, half with the lore of death, half with the lore of the deep. So she's a hybrid lord that can do lots of damage in various ways. She also provides some healing to nearby friendly troops, has some damage boost abilities and things, a direct damage spell to nearby enemies as well. She's got a lot going on, so she's a pretty beefy legendary lord. Onto one of the heroes with the Fim, Finmore. This is pretty much a basic melee Fimir. It's got armor sundering, magical attacks, decent weapon strength, although not armor piercing. Does have a bonus versus infantry though, so great for fighting in crowds, good for supporting the front line perhaps, or maybe even taking on other lords and heroes. And then another hero option, the Boglar Shaman. Pretty much a little swamp goblin. He's not going to do too much in the melee, but he comes with half the lore of deep and half the lore of the little war, I think. So going to be able to provide some magic. If you don't have magic on your lord, you're going to want a little Boglar Shaman to come and do some of that magic for you. And speaking of Boglars, that brings us to the infantry Boglars, which again is pretty much just little swamp goblins that are perhaps closer to Noblars maybe than goblins, as they don't have a shield and they do have that big old Noblar nose. But the swampy vibes on this unit look very cool. The ear fins really do give them that amphibious swampy vibe. Onto some more useful tier 1 infantry, the Shurls. These have pretty low combat stats, although reasonable weapon strength. Not a lot of armor or leadership though, so perhaps more in line with skinks. Should be able to get a little bit of damage done to lesser foes before they rout off at least. And then there's Shurl Scouts that are pretty much the same thing, except they have a ranged attack which is anti-large, which is very nice, making them pretty good value for money if you can get that ammo used on the large targets. So they have the upside of a ranged attack, but the downside to them is that they have much worse melee stats than the regular Shurls, so they really just need to stick to their ranged role. Into some basic stronger infantry then, Infim Warriors. These are a good frontline choice, lots of melee defense with that shield, have a bit of armor on them, have some good leadership, not fantastic damage output, so more of a holding frontline than a damage dealer. But that's absolutely fine because there's plenty of damage dealers in this army, such as the Fim Warrior Great Weapons. Pretty much the same idea, just not as tough without the shield, but they do have an armor-piercing weapon. So the ones to go after the more heavily armored units or to be able to punch through the enemy frontline. Great looking models on all of these as usual. Maybe the weapons on these Fim Warriors could be a little better. It looks a little basic for the rest of the model, I think, but overall, still very, very nice looking units. Into some bigger boys then, the tier 3 infantry, Fianna Fim. These are basically the Fimir warriors from the Norskan roster. They've got armor sundering, magical attacks, big armor piercing, weapon strength, decent armor and leadership. There's also an ability on all these Fimir units that gives them plus 20% missile resistance while their leadership is above 50%. So that's their kind of race bonus or faction bonus, only for the Fimir units though, so not on the Goblars, Boblars, Noglars, Boglars, that's the one. Got there in the end. And then there's the Fianna Fim Great Weapons. These ones pretty much the same as the previous unit, just they have an anti-large bonus with that big two-handed weapon. Again, pretty much from the Norskan roster, these ones, their role, obviously, to bonk big things on the head. And then there's Fim Death Quest. These ones a little bit different. They don't have armor piercing, still got some good damage dealing stats though with melee attack and weapon strength. Nice charge bonus too. These ones, however, are unbreakable. They have frenzy. They can go into rampage though, so they're kind of their own just crazy weird thing. Potentially a lot of damage to put out there if they can get into the right targets that aren't too heavily armored. Onto a ranged unit in the Balefiend Apprentices. These ones not so good in the melee, but that's because they have a magical ranged attack with a tasty range of 180. So there are some ranged options in this Fimir roster. It's not all melee rushing or anything. And again, a very cool looking unit. That staff with the magical ranged attack really giving them some mysterious wizardy vibes. I like it. If you'd rather have some straight up damage smashy boys, then you could go for the Fim Mistmore. These have big weapon strength, armor piercing, a really nice charge bonus as well, so you probably want to keep these ones moving every now and again to make the most of that charge bonus and really get the damage output going for these big horny boys. Now to something a little more sneaky with the Swamp Demons. These are very, very cool looking unit, that black and yellow, quite striking. These have got nice weapon strength and a decent charge bonus, not fantastic melee attack or melee defense, do have poison and magical attacks though. These will probably want to try and cycle charge a little bit to make the most of their charge bonus to beef up that melee attack. But the selling point of these creepers is their Vanguard deployment and stalk, so you can position them, Vanguard deploy them behind the enemy. If they've got ranged missiles, artillery, they can sneak up on those and take them out, probably before the enemy can do anything about it. So they're very nice in that role. Now into some cavalry and monster type units, starting with the Moorhounds. These are pretty much your usual doggo unit. Nice mossy, grassy, swampy vibes on them. They do have a physical resistance, Vanguard deployment, and magical attack, so there's a few things they could do, but mostly going to be good for getting after those missiles and artillery, harassing backlines and things like that. All the stuff that doggos do best. And then for a cavalry straight out of your nightmares, the Knuckleaves, if I'm saying that correctly. Nice armor-piercing damage, pretty good combat stats overall. Not a huge charge bonus, so not a shock cavalry. More of a melee cavalry with a little bit of melee defense, although their lack of armor may make them suffer in a prolonged fight. They do have magical attacks and frostbite as well, which is a little weird considering their weapon is on fire. But a pretty strong unit that gives a nice mobility option to the Fimir roster, although the Fimir themselves are pretty quick anyway. And then to some monstrous cavalry with the Feral Bog Beasts. These are going to be more of your shock cavalry type unit. Big weapon strength, nice charge bonus, not a ton of melee defense. These do have poison as well. They do seem to be lacking a bottom jaw, which makes them look pretty creepy. But another nice cavalry type flanking mobility option, or maybe good for mixing in with the front line with that poison to help out the front line if it should need it. There's also Bog Beast Raiders. Now this is the Regiment of Renown version because the normal model seemed a little bit broken, so just to see the full model and how it should look, this has got Fimir riding atop the Bog Beasts, and it seems to make them a lot tougher. They now have a shield, more armor, more melee defense, less charge bonus, so a little bit more of a tough surviving unit rather than a damage dealer like the Feral Bog Beasts. And then to possibly the best looking unit of this roster, the Fog Shrine of Balor. This thing, pulled by a couple of armored bog beasts, looks like a kind of tower on wheels with an octopus wrapped around it. It looks incredibly good. As for what it can do, it's basically an artillery. It has a massive missile attack, 1k damage, 320 range, fire and magical attacks on that as well. It kind of functions like a Luminarch, takes a while to build up the attack, but it's very strong when it goes off. Its melee stats leave a lot to be desired, so it should probably avoid that for the most part. Although it will want to stay near the action because it does give a buff to leadership and to missile resistance for nearby friendly troops as well. Onto a single entity monster, the Bog Octopus. Very similar to the legendary Lord Kroll, just without the magic. Very big damage dealer, anti-infantry, so just charge this thing into the enemy infantry and let it go to town. Although its melee defense not great, and especially being a big single entity monster that could be surrounded by a lot of enemies, you might need to be somewhat careful with it. As it is reasonably quick and does have terror, charging around trying to terrorize things might be a good way to go with this Bogtopus, as I'm going to call it. And if a Bogtopus wasn't terrifying enough, maybe you need a Demonomaniac. That's a fun name. This thing, basically a bloodthirster. It's the size of a bloodthirster. You might not be able to tell from just looking at it here, but it's got big weapon strength, armor piercing, anti-large as well. Just a massive damage dealer, which is already pretty terrifying as it is, physical resistance as well there, but it also has regeneration. So good luck killing the bastard. A very nasty single entity monster. Obviously though, it doesn't fly like a bloodthirster, just everything else about it, bloodthirster. So that's a large chunk of this OVN Lost Factions Fimir roster. That's not all the units, there is more. You can check them out yourself. I'll put a link in the description if you want to check out this mod. And it's not just a roster to this mod as well, there is full campaigns in here for the two legendary lords that they've got. You start in different positions, this one over in Lustria, it's got all unique buildings to the Fimir, all the units are applied, just like a normal proper campaign. So if you want a new experience from all the factions you've already played in Total War Warhammer, these mods are a great way to go. There's one for Albion, which I've done a video of as well. So if you're looking for a fresh faction to play in Total War Warhammer while you wait for any official content, these OVN mods are pretty fantastic. But there we go. I hope you've enjoyed this. Thanks for watching, and thank you to all the patrons and YouTube members that support this channel. I will see you in the future.